Okay students, now this video will be on example 22b. Express the following in the form of r cos theta plus minus alpha or r sin theta plus minus alpha. So first we're going to check, we are going to add sine and cos. So among these four formulas, we're going to find which formula that has sine plus cos. So the formula that has sine plus cos is the second formula here, and if you see r a sin theta plus minus b cos theta equals to r sin theta plus alpha. Okay, so we're going to write this first. So once we have written this, r sin theta plus alpha, we can use compound angle sin theta cos alpha plus r cos theta sin alpha. So that's how we expand r sin theta plus alpha. Next we're gonna compare. So we're gonna compare square root of 3 sin theta with r sin theta cos alpha. Okay, square root of 3 sin theta equals to r sin theta cos alpha. So if you can see that both sides have sine theta, we can divide the expression with sine theta and we will have square root of 3 equals to r cos alpha, or r cos alpha equals to square root of 3. So this will be equation number 1. Now for equation number 2, we're going to compare cos theta with cos theta. Okay, so cos theta equals to r cos theta sin alpha. So we have cos theta on the left hand side and right hand side. So we're going to divide the whole expression with cos theta. Cos theta divided by cos theta, we will have 1 equals to r sin alpha. Or we're going to write here r sin alpha equals to 1. So this will be equation number 2. Okay. Now remember, our aim is to find r and alpha. So to find r, we're going to take equation 1 square plus 2 square. So 1 square, equation 1 square would be r square cos square alpha plus equation 2 square r square sin square alpha. That's for your left hand side. For your right hand side, r cos alpha, right hand side is square root of 3. Square root of 3 square is 3. For your second equation, your right hand side is 1. 1 square is 1. So r square cos square alpha plus r square sin square alpha equals to 3 plus 1. So we're going to factorize r square here. So we will have cos square alpha plus sin square alpha equals to 4. Okay. So we know cos square plus sin square is 1. So we will get r as plus minus 2. Remember, r is greater than 0. So r is 2. We still need to find the value of alpha. Now students, to find the value of alpha, we will take equation 2 divided by equation 1. Okay, so equation 2 is r sin alpha divided by equation 1 is r cos alpha equals to, on your right hand side, equation 2 is 1 and equation 1 is square root of 3. So r sin alpha divided by r cos alpha equals to 1 divided by square root of 3. Next, we're going to eliminate r on your left hand side. And sin alpha divided by cos alpha is tangent alpha. So we get tangent alpha equals to 1 over square root of 3. So if you use your calculator to find alpha, you will get alpha as 30 degree. Remember, alpha is an acute angle. So we will only consider alpha 30 degree. Now, since we already find the value of r and the value of alpha, finally we can give our answer. Square root of sin theta plus cos theta equals to, earlier we decide to use 2 sine theta plus 30 degree. Okay, so what we have done, we managed to express sine plus cos in terms of sine. Okay, so that's for example 22B.